Peace, love, light, peace, power, and protection, you beautiful, beautiful people. This is our season. It is Scorpio season. What it do, beloveds? I will each and every one of you are feeling grounded, balanced, and in alignment. I will your focus. I will you are feeling happy and excited about your solar returns that are coming up. If it has already passed, happy, happy, happy solar return, and many, 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 many more. I will you all have a beautiful, beautiful time loving on yourselves, and I will that you are celebrated so much by your beloveds, by your loved ones, that this is a joyous time for you all. And I'm sending infinite love and light. I'm sending virtual hugs. I'm sending virtual daps, high fives, all that good stuff. I will that it is a special time. It should be. I will that you all are feeling grounded, balanced, and in alignment, beautiful people. I will that you are not getting distracted by the distractions and that you are staying focused on you, yourself, and you. This is a time to be selfish. If any other time, this is the time. During your season to be selfish, and not selfish in a negative way, but selfish where you are prioritizing you and putting you first, because we all know how Scorpios do. You are very loving, you wear your heart on your sleeve, you're constantly giving to others, you're always available, you're loyal, you're faithful. But I want you to do all of the aforementioned for yourselves. This is your season, so allow yourselves to be celebrated. You know, allow people to celebrate you, allow people to even compliment you and shower you with the love that you so rightfully deserve, beloveds. To any of you that may be tuning and tapping in for the first time, I go by the name of Q, and this is Clairaudient Truth Speaker, obviously. The way things work on my side of the planet is I do incorporate music into my readings, and so the name of the songs, lyrics of the songs, name of the artist, maybe even the timestamp on the clock, it will all correlate to whatever I may be channeling intuitively, as well as what the cards are showing and the music that's playing, and it all just blends very beautifully. So my spiel here is eat the fish, spit out the bones, meaning if it doesn't apply, just simply let it fly by. Never try to force anything to be your story. My readings are also timeless. So whenever the video has popped up in your feed, or whenever you felt compelled to click play, either by means of the title, the timestamp, whatever it is that drew you to the reading, that was in fact divine timing and in divine order that you've done so, beloveds. So for each and every one of you beautiful souls that are returning, you already know what it is. Love is love is love is love is love. I send you all extra love because you know I love y'all that much. I am not going to take any more time away from the reading. As promised, this is another bonus, and I'm also do some readings for November, of course, for my November Scorpios. I know there was a couple of 11-11 babies and 11-3. My grandfather, who is an ancestor, his solar return is on November 3rd, and my great-grandfather shares my solar return, or I should say I share a solar return with my great-grandfather, George Portia. I send infinite love and light to each of them, but those powerful elders, those patriarchs, I have the beautiful experience of sharing a zodiac with my beloved great-granddaddy and my granddaddy. So I'm just sending them all the love and just, you know, really thankful. So we are going to do it big for the Scorpios. You know, I don't even pump out these many readings. So these are bonuses, and this is just my way of saying thank you. You know, thank you to each and every one of you who tune in and tap in. I am not your traditional reader, and there is no shots being taken. I do provide deep dive writing readings because I like to paint a very clear and concise picture so that you walk away feeling like, dang, that felt like a personal. You know what I'm talking about? So that's how I do things on my side of the planet. And it does, you know, when if you pay attention, you'll see that the way things typically work is before I even touch the cards, I will speak on what I'm feeling, what energy, whatever transmissions come through, and then, you know, 9 times or 10 times out of 10, you'll see that those very same cards I may have mentioned, or the same energy that I may have expounded upon, it will, you know, show up in the reading. So we're going to see what comes out for this reading. I really thank you all for just being here. I appreciate you all. I don't ever want you to feel like I take you all for granted. And I know y'all don't take me for granted because I wouldn't allow that. So we're going to go ahead and delve and dive and see what we got coming in, going out, going on, beloveds. So without further ado, let's go ahead and, you know me, I like to do my deep inhales, exhales, and then we shall proceed with the read after we pay homage to the ancestors. And for anyone that may be questioning, what's going on with the picture? How come I don't see anything? Well, that's because this is the Dark Matter series. And so you're not going to see a picture. I don't want to be on camera. For those of you who that may have missed that, because you'll be surprised, I'll say something and folks will still leave a comment like, something's wrong with your picture. You might want, I'm like, oh Lord Jesus, active listening, beloveds. But let's go ahead and proceed with the read, Ashe. I call upon the elements of water, fire, earth, air, ether, and spirit. Ashe. I ask our beautiful angels, archangels, ancestors, ascended masters, spirit guides, deities, animal totems, earth, Mother Gaia, universe, source, the divine, most high God, our creator, to shine a powerful, powerful message of love and of light. I call personally upon Baba Obatala, Mama Oya, and Baba Ogun to bless me with the intuition and discernment of my cards, help me to pick up on the energy, number, synchronicity, and vibrations of my cards. And so it is. So mote it be. Ashe, ashe, ashe. Yo, beautiful souls. So what we have playing right now on the playlist, or what we have on the time clock, let me show you that first and foremost, because you know I like to show and prove, beloveds. So let me go ahead, I'm gonna show you. So I'm just let you know, like, I will show you things if I want you to see it. So what we have playing now is we have Abi Okai, and this is called Running, and it is currently 7:59 on the clock. So we didn't even hit 8 o'clock yet, so it's 7:59. So that 7:59 breaks down to 3. 7 plus 5 is 12. That breaks down to 3. So that 12 going into 9, that will also, anything going into the number 9 is always 3. So that's how I break down my numbers, because I know a lot of you are like, what are you talking about? 7 plus 5 plus 9 is not 3. But if you break all of the numbers that comes down, it will reduce to 3. But I digress. So with this running, first and foremost, the 12 is the hangman. So perhaps some of you all have been in a space where you've been kind of like, you know, you've been put into some sort of, maybe you're in solitude, you know, maybe you're in a space where you're working on the self, doing some introspective work, reflecting. Maybe spirit has put some of you in a sacrificial position to look at things from a different perspective. Maybe this is someone else's perspective, looking at you in a whole new light, looking at you with a whole different lens or a whole different perspective, or maybe they've perceived you in a wrong way, because now with them looking at you from a different vantage point, it's almost like they could see you in that empress status. Someone's heart could also be affected by this. There could be some real big emotions that someone may be realizing, and this could be someone who was like a runner chaser, someone who ran away from this connection, maybe out of fear, or maybe out of just perceiving you in a wrong way. Maybe they had you pegged out to be one way, and now that they're looking at you in a different way because spirit stepped in, it's like they can see you as you are. They can see you as someone who's reached a level of self-mastery, or someone who has evolved or manifested something in your life that is huge, whether you've transformed, gone through some sort of transformation, or whether you have evolved in your ways of being. This is something that is highly, highly attractive. And they're also becoming very aware of perhaps mistakes they made or opportunities they may have missed. So this is someone who's like observing you from behind the scenes, and with Abby Okai singing Running. I don't know if you all saw that. So let me show you again, because I think that thing was there. So, and it's currently 8:01, so that's 9. So this 9 is confirming, like, because I said solitude earlier. So I do feel like this is someone who's been in like a hermit mode, or someone you haven't really had much contact with. I mean, this is someone maybe that you maybe even you've established boundaries, so they may feel like your walls are up, your guards are up, and this is someone now who is being forced, because when you're in that hangman position, that is a sacrificial position that spirit will step in and force you into, because you're being blinded to the truth or blinded to the facts, or maybe someone's just simply aloof. So this is forcing someone to see something differently, to, you know, look at things from a completely different lens. And this is really becoming very apparent to someone that perhaps they've missed an opportunity, or that they're seeing you as an empress, because that three that the 12 reduces to becomes the number 3, which is the empress. That also could be the 3 of swords, where I was feeling initial hurt, you know, and with running, that could hurt anyone, because that could be abandonment, that could be, you know, unrequited love. If someone feels like someone is running away, or someone felt like they ran away from a connection, and now they're realizing that the hurt that they're experiencing is due to their past mistakes, or due to their inability to see you in the right way, or in the true light, in your true light, I should say, it's causing them to have some regrets. So we're going to tap in, you know, with that number 9. I absolutely feel you all are super protective of yourselves, super protective of your energies, your peace. You are not allowing anyone to come in and interfere or run in interference in the peace that you have been able to establish for yourselves. I definitely feel like with the 9, I'm seeing like the 9 of wands, where you have set up those walls because you've experienced a lot of disappointment and you've learned from those mistakes. And that's why you have built these walls up and you have established these boundaries, so as not to continue to be taken for granted. Because after you have that 9, it's the 10 of wands, which means you're completely overwhelmed. You've been carrying the burden and the weight on your shoulders all on your own. And so that's where you step out of toxicity and you go into defense mode. And so that's the mode you're in, is a very defensive mode, where you're not taking anybody's mess and you're not going to take too kindly to anyone insulting your intelligence or trying to take from you and not provide deposits. This is not just come in and take what you want and leave. That's not what you're putting up with anymore. And I feel like this is something that others are starting to understand, even those who may have taken advantage in the past because of your kindness, because of your openness and your unconditional love. You may have found that you were being taken advantage of, or you may have even befallen to your own insecurities, which has allowed others to kind of caused you to overcompensate in those toxic relationships. But you've since learned from that, and that's why now others are looking at you differently, because you are different. You know, when you think of the 9, I also think of the 9 of cups, which is that me, myself, and I, de la soul energy. And that energy is really of self-love, and self-love always makes you attractive. It also shows that you are pouring into yourself, whether by means of being creative, or whether by means of just working on yourself, working on your finances, working on your stability, your security, on your legacy, on your family. You are focused on you, and that's where that energy has shifted for someone, because now they're seeing you as you truly are. You've always been this person, but this experience where you may have been taken for granted, or where you may have been abandoned, or where someone may have ran from you, or where there was unrequited love, or there was no reciprocity, you've learned from that, and now you're pouring into yourself, and you're teaching others how to treat you now, because you absolutely are being watched. I'm also feeling a sense of the 9 of pentacles, where you've really started to focus on your stability, on your finances, on your credit. You know, you could be saving up for a home, you could be cleaning up your credit, you could be learning, you know, some sort of financial literacy, you could be taking classes to do your own taxes. There's something where you have leveled up in your understanding of finances, of independence, of, you know, establishing that sense of self-sufficiency for yourself. And this is something that's also making you very attractive, because the work that you've put into it, there's like tangibles, you know, you have something tangible, whether you are able to purchase some big ticket item, or you were able to, like I said, put down on a home or purchase a home, whatever you're doing, it's like you can see your hard work. You know, there is something tangible that others can see. Wow, you did it big, or you have leveled up, or you have you've succeeded, you've reached some level of success in your life, and that's very attractive. So what we have playing right now is we have Nas, and this is called One Mic. Oh, it just went off, and then another song popped up. So I did see it. Let me see if I could get it back. I can't. But we had Nas, One Mic. So some of you could be orators, communicators. You could disseminate information. Some of you may have your own podcasts. Nas is from Queens, New York. Some of you can be from New York, Queens. Someone may just simply see you as a queen, as I said earlier, with that 12 that we opened up the reading that breaks down to 3. That's the Empress. So the Empress embodies all of the characteristics and all of the attributes of the queens. Every queen of cups, swords, queen of wands, pentacles. If you're a king, same thing is applicable. You embody all of the characteristics of each king, of all of the kings rather. And so this is making you even more attractive. There's also this energy with One Mic that I feel like if you do have a podcast, like it's a very unique approach that you have. You're doing something different, something innovative. Maybe even the topics of conversations are something that you don't see many other influencers or YouTubers discuss. And this is cutting you, you know, you're like cut from a different cloth, or you're creating your own lane. And that's something very, very unique. So it's something that you're doing that's very unique. And I feel it's going to pick up with that One Mic. It's like you have some sort of opportunity to break through. You know, there's a breakthrough that occurs because whatever you're doing is like, I'm hearing the word groundbreaking. And this is going to transform your life if you stick it out. If you continue to master your craft, I feel like you're going to start seeing more people subscribe. You're going to start seeing more traction, more, you know, like more traffic on that site, on that platform, and continue to do your thing. I'm also hearing secure your spot, because whatever you're discussing, it may be something that could be what others might deem as, what do you call that? It could be something that could be more taboo, or it could draw a lot of, you know, a lot of bots. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people who are like, they call people, they've completely topsy-turvied the word woke, because there was a time where woke meant you had knowledge of self, and now it's like woke people are people who saying that, you know, a man can have a baby. You know, like I'm confused, but I digress. But this is like, you, whatever you're discussing is something that can be, there's a word that I'm looking for. Give me one moment. Apologies. But yes, so it's going to be some sort of like, it's going to be, there's going to be a lot of back and forth. I just see people quarreling. I see people kind of like in these debates, you know. So it may behoove you to like establish another platform like Rumble or something like that, if you're going to discuss topics that can cause a lot of debating and going back and forth, or even, you know, where you might get censored. You know, we've seen a lot of people who are disseminating the truth speakers, their channels are being shadow banned, they're being cut down, because they're really trying to censor you know, a lot of content creators who are bringing the truth to light, which is something that I feel should never happen, because this is still the free world and we should have freedom of speech. And unfortunately, they want us to be almost brainwashed with their talking points. So if you think differently than they do, then they see you as a threat. So it's really just a lot of negative things going on in the world where they're trying to take away our ability to speak freely about our experiences. And it may very well lead you down a path where, you know, your channel may be shadow banned. So that's why I'm just kind of telling you to, you know, beforehand, if that is the case, and if you know that you do discuss some of those taboo topics, you know, just make sure you establish another platform so that you're not just kind of left assed out, so to speak. But I digress. So let's go ahead and see what the cards have to say. That's just what I'm picking up intuitively, beloveds. What we have playing on the playlist right now is we have Aha, and this is called Take On Me. And this is from like the 80s. So I just did the same thing I did in the former reading. So look at that. That's what I was playing or attempting to show you, is Take On Me. And so with all of you with Aha, I definitely am feeling an epiphany. I was feeling that that individual, whether that's your energy or whomever you're attracting to you, someone could absolutely be having that epiphanous moment or that Aha moment, as this is Aha playing. With Take On Me, I do get a sense of someone has a different take on you. Like someone, as I said, is looking at you from a completely different perspective. They have a completely different opinion of you. So this is beautiful. What we have on the bottom of the numerology deck is we have the happy ending, number 93, and that's another 12. Remember, we started the reading with 12, and so we have another 93, I mean another 12. So with this 12, this is showing me that absolutely someone sees you as the Empress or the Emperor. They see you as someone who is very much a powerhouse, very attractive, very intuitive, very maternal or paternal, the matriarch or patriarch, someone who's a master manifester, someone who births new ideas, new ways of thinking, someone who is very, very innovative, as I was just describing. So you are taking the reins, moving in the direction of your life, bossing up, doing things your way, and you're not apologizing for it. I do feel whoever this is has a completely different perspective. It's like they're almost taken aback as to how wrong they were about you. But with this, I'm getting a sense of like, if this is someone that you have lost contact with or that you have not spoken to, or if someone is currently suffering from heartache and loss, because I was picking up even on the Three of Swords, I feel like there's going to be a happy ending. Even if the way things may have ended or transpired, if this is a different or a person from the past, I should say, if it didn't end well, I feel like, or if you didn't leave that situation in a good, if it wasn't in a good place, I feel like the ending is going to be happier. Like there's going to be something that turns around, or there's going to be something unexpected that could occur. And this is very beautiful. And it looks like what's going to happen is someone's going to have some sort of ego death. So this is why there's a happy ending, because someone is getting out of their own way and someone is starting to look at things from a different perspective. As I said, with Aha singing Take On Me, someone's having an epiphany, an epiphanous moment. So they're now seeing things as they truly are. They're seeing you as the divine feminine, as the divine masculine. With this bright yellow card, this is someone who is very luminous to the truth, to the facts. They're seeing you in your truth. They're seeing you in your power. They're seeing you in your light. And this is something that they may not have ever seen before. So this is a different take that they're having on you, a different perspective. And it has a lot to do with that moment of pause, with that moment, that spirit, that source, that their angels, their ancestors, guides, that put them, placed them in that space so that they could come into this epiphany, so that they can come into alignment even with you, or with you with them. So let's tap in, see what the cards have to say. That's just what I'm picking up, beloveds. So divine spirit of peace, power, and protection, let me get a message for my beloved Scorpios. What is the overall energy for my beloved Scorpios? Divine spirit of peace, power, and protection, what is the overall energy for my beloved Scorpios? Let me get a message of peace, power, protection. I just saw the 33. It just kind of almost popped out. So that speaks to that 33. That's a double number. Whenever I see that number, that's the energy of who you're attracting to you. And the 33 is saying communication. So someone could be communicating with you either telepathically or intuitively, or someone could really be thinking a lot about you. So this is a lot of cerebral activity. This is someone who's constantly thinking, someone who's constantly in a contemplative state. So this speaks to also them having some sort of illumination, because it's that bright yellow card, and that yellow is it reminds me of the sun. That's like having a wow, like it's like the light is bright, the truth is revealed, or there's some sort of clarity that someone comes to. But this is what someone is feeling right now. We have Queen, and remember we had Nas earlier, and I was picking up on the Queens, New York. So we have Queen. So someone does see you as a queen. That three is associated with the Empress, and so I do feel like there is someone who is, you know, looking at you as a queen, as a king, as someone that is absolutely beautiful, attractive, someone that they desire to be with, or someone they desire to communicate with. They could be watching you also. This could be someone who is very skilled at astral traveling. If they're not astral traveling, maybe they're finding themselves having dreams. And if this is someone you're familiar with, that could be very, almost like a little intimidating, you know, because they don't understand why you're so heavy on their mind. Especially if this is someone from the past that you haven't spoken to, it's just like, it's so intense that it's almost a little scary. So the card that flew out is 26, love partnership, as I was shuffling. So this is a bonus message because it just popped out. So this is someone from the past. When I see this, there could have been something that happened karmically. Maybe this is a karmic lover. Maybe this is someone, like I said earlier, who could have been like, things could have transpired where they could have been unrequited love. Someone could have been running. Someone could have been looking at the situation as, you know, they weren't ready to get tied down, or maybe they were someone who was kind of like just soiling their royal oats, really just trying to play the field and see what else was out there until you were no longer in the picture. That's when they had that epiphanous moment, like, wow, what I was feeling, I was suppressing. And it could have been because of pride, because we saw that pride. But now we see someone's having an ego death, and they're putting their pride to the side, and they're trying to figure out a way or how to approach you to open up dialogue, to have this conversation, because now they're realizing that what they were not aware of or even willing to admit in terms of their feelings toward you, they are now starting to recognize that it is absolutely love. So this is a very beautiful energy. So with this 26 love, that's giving the 8 of cups. I was speaking of the 8 early, you know, that energy where you now have self-love. And the 8 of cups is when you walk away from someone that was leaving you feeling emotionally bankrupt, because that's what I get when I see this 26 love partnership. So something that occurred in a love partnership, because this is the overall energy this card pulled out. And remember, we have Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody playing. So with this Queen, I definitely am getting a sense that this is someone who has looked at this situation, and they're realizing, you know, something could have happened karmically to this person, or maybe this was someone that was brought into your life to teach you karmic lessons. But I feel that the lesson that you learned was, I can love myself. I have to love myself. It's an inside job. So if you were pouring and giving and constantly overcompromising and constantly providing someone a safe space, and they couldn't reciprocate that same gesture to you, I feel like it got old and you moved on, because you realized you were a queen or a king and you deserved exactly what you gave. So that was a bonus message. That's what pulled out. We still have this 33 on the bottom of the deck. So after all that shuffling, this is someone that does want to speak to you. They see you as a queen. They realize and recognize they've made some sort of mistake. So with this 33, I'm absolutely feeling, because this 6 and this 8, that 8 and 6 breaks down to 14. So this is definitely someone with the 5 that breaks down to 5. So the 5 deals with the throat chakra. So it's just double confirmation that they want to communicate. They're trying to send you telepathic or intuitive messages, which could be the reason why, you know, if you are just randomly thinking about somebody you haven't spoken to in a while, it could be because they're constantly, you're constantly renting space in their mind. sign or vice versa. So whatever this is, you know, you kind of got to fit the pieces as they go. So let's go ahead. I'm going to do a couple more shuffles and then I'm going to cut the deck. So Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection. Let's get this overall energy, beloveds. Let's get a message of peace, power, and protection. Thank you, Spirit. Cut the deck. And I just cut until I feel like it is right or until I hear Spirit say that's it. Thank you, Spirit. All right, that's it. And the bottom of the deck, overall energy. And we have the number 5, and that says change. So the number 5 and the number 26 reduces to 13. Remember, I was talking to death because I was hearing, you know, the nail in the coffin. That's what I heard earlier. So that means that there is some sort of death. There's something transforming. And a death can be either literal, maybe the death of a loved one may have change someone's perspective, or maybe just you going through that transformation or going through some sort of rebirth has triggered something in another person. But this 13 reduces to the number 4, which is associated with the Emperor. So that divine masculine, someone could be changing, or someone is wanting to change a situation, or maybe that karmic situation has caused something to change. And now, you know, that's led to, you know, the ending of a cycle or the ending of a circumstance, which means there's a new beginning. You're on the precipice of a new start. What we have playing right now is Michael Jackson, Rising Power to the King. And this is Billie Jean. Someone's name could be Billy or Jean, first, middle, or last. But this is, or someone's name could be Michael Jackson, Michael or Jackson, first, middle, or last. So with this energy, someone could have been a crazy Michael Jackson fan as a child. I don't know one person that wasn't. I know I was. You know, I didn't go as far as having like the jacket and all of that. That was my brother. But I'd be damned if I ain't learned every move. So you all could have been and still are, you know, like Michael Jackson fans, or someone could be from Gary, Indiana, or California, or someone could have went to visit, you know, Neverland, you know, or something, or maybe even his burial site. You know, someone could have taken pictures, or, you know, someone could have been a live hard fan, I should say. With the 37 time out on the bottom of the deck, I absolutely am feeling like, as I said earlier, there was a lot of work being put in, which means that you have been off the radar. You have not been on the scene. You haven't been out. You've been just kind of keeping to yourself and just working through whatever you've been kind of mastering within yourself internally as well as externally. As I said, maybe your finances, maybe your household, just getting things in order. You know, that's the work. So even if you weren't on the scenes, you wasn't just sitting in the house moping and self-loathing and woe is me. It's like you've been grinding, you know, and it's very evident. That's why people are now starting to look at you differently. That's why you're more attractive. That's why people are wanting to kind of reach out, because they're liking what they see. They like these changes. But that 37 also is 10. So that means that, you know, if you have been off the scene, you about to come out, baby. You about to be out there. You know, you about to be outside, because, you know, it could be because your solar return is coming up. And a lot of people are going to be around you, surrounding you with love. Or maybe you are, you know, doing what I'm doing, which is throwing myself a big old 50th birthday bash this year. Yes, I'm is. And it's going to be grand. I got family coming in from all over the place. And it's just going to be beautiful. So you could be celebrating yourself. You know, you could also just have people just wanting to surprise you and celebrate you, because they're seeing you in a whole new light. That 10 also is associated with the Wheel of Fortune. So if there have been, you know, those moments of pause or moments where you just kind of took a rest, you know, you were at that little resting stop, just kind of focusing on yourself. As I said, I feel like you're coming out of that phase, and you're going to have some sort of brand new beginning, or you're on the precipice of a new start. And I just feel like things are turning around. The wheel is now turning in your favor. And I even feel like there's money coming in, wishes coming in, dreams are coming true, like something magnificent is taking place. So this is a beautiful energy. So Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection. Thank you. That just popped out. Dang, you got two cards that just popped out. So the bottom of the deck, we have 11, individuality, and this will be on the bottom of the deck when you pull how this person feels about you. So that 11, individuality, means that you are independent, which is what I was picking up on. So the cards that flew out is we have self-discipline. This is who or what you're attracting to you. This could be your energy or the person that you're attracting to you. We also have 67, which is physical activity. So it's very evident that someone has been very, very intentional about the work they've been doing on the self, because that self-discipline is all-encompassing of self-love, self-worth, self-value. And that means that you have taken the time to work on yourself to the point where you know, okay, there's work I got to do. So that's self-improvement. You know, you're self-aware, you're self-determined. So when you have that type of discipline, you're always doing the things that you feel are going to make you a better version of you. And that shows the physical activity, which means you've been very intentional with that. That 67 is 13. So that's the transformation. That's how you were able to transform, because you actively worked on the self. You didn't just sit around and mope and whine and complain and be a victim. You did the actual work. So this is a very powerful, powerful statement. I feel also whoever you're attracting to you could also be someone who has learned from you. Someone who has also taken kind of like a page out of your book, because they're obviously observing, or they're obviously having some means or some method to watch, you know, because this is someone who has some level of regret, you know, because we see that 12 that opened up the reading, which is the Hangman. So they're kind of sitting with their thoughts, you know, and not just their thoughts, but they're also seeing something differently. So it's like, even if they had a different perspective, it's like now that perspective or that opinion of you has also changed, because they're seeing you differently now, which means, or it would insinuate, that they're still watching or they're still aware. So this is a very powerful energy. So far we have 8 and 5, that's 13, that's 4. 4 and 5 is 9. 9 and 4 is 4. So this is a divine masculine. All these cards right now, and we're on the energy of who or what you're attracting to you. This is 4. So someone is definitely, they've taken a page out of your book. Someone's going through some sort of transformation. Someone is matured. Someone is leveled up. The 41 reduces to 5, which is dealing with the Hierophant. That speaks to someone who has some sort of knowledge. Like they've either sat at the feet of elders in their family, whether it's an uncle, whether it's an auntie, whether it's their mother, their father, their umi, their baba. Maybe it's a master teacher. Maybe it's just someone they look up to, and they're getting game. And this is leading them to self-improvement, as I said, because that 60, that 41, pardon me, self-discipline shows that someone is working on the self. Because the Hierophant, that's a student, that's like tutelage. That's like a student. That's someone who is just soaking up game. That's someone who's really just kind of learning and even being, you know, kind of chastised to some degree, but they are still learning and they are becoming more aware or more, they're more in tune with themselves, because that self-discipline just to me just speaks to maturation. So this is very powerful. I love that. And so what we have right now is Guns N' Roses, Sweet Child O' Mine. So Guns N' Roses. So that's a rock band. So definitely what I'm getting, especially with the Guns N' Roses, you know, this is like someone who could, with the Sweet Child of Mine also, like this is someone who may feel that you're sweet, because I'm about to pull, you know, the card for how they feel about you. And sweet is what's really, you know, kind of jumping out at me. But with Guns N' Roses, some of you females may be like, I'm hearing like some of y'all could be snipers. You could be going to the range, learning how to shoot, not just regular guns, cute little prissy guns, but you're like shooting like ARs, and like I just see feminine energies like at the gun range. Maybe you've joined some sort of gun club, but you're learning how to self-defense, like how to carry a weapon, clean your weapon, disarm the weapon. Like you're learning everything about the, you know, how to appropriately or properly handle a gun, because I just get with Guns N' Roses like a a strong, badass, feminine energy who may be going to the range, you know, with a group of females, with a group of women, and you all are just like Billy badasses out here. Y'all are like shooting, even if this is like, you know, some of you could be going with your children, with your daughters to teach them. We in some crazy times, and self-defense is very important, whether it's by means of a gun or your hands, your feet. Some of you all could really be, you know, taking it very serious that, you know, in these crazy days, you want to be able to protect yours. And so I just see some badass women who know, like I said, carrying guns that's damn near bigger than them and knowing how to handle it. That's what I'm seeing in my mind's eye. What we have on the bottom of the deck, again, is that individuality. And we are about to pull the card for how someone feels about you. So they do see you as someone who's independent, who's enjoying your singlehood, who has been able to rebuild, you know, after something was destroyed, and you are very self-sufficient, independent. This 11 is a power number. You could be getting a lot of downloads. They may see you as very intuitive, a very psychic, a channeler, a sorcerer of sorts, because you have this. Not only the 11 opens up a portal where you could get those downloads, those transmissions, but it's also reduces to 2, which is associated with the high priest, the high priestess, and they carry divine knowledge, divine wisdom. And so you can teeter between the spirit realm and even this earthly realm, and you receive a lot of ancient wisdom in that way. And so someone could very well see you as someone is very in tune, you know, very in tune, very aware, you know, very aware of what's going on around you, very aware of even what's going on within you. But this is definitely someone who's sweet on you. So let's tap in. So how does this person that our beloved Scorpios are attracting to them feel about them? My spirit of peace, power, and protection. Thank you, spirit. And so how they feel about you, I can't even make this up. It's number 6, love. And that deals with a past person. I was picking up a past person because I think of not only the lovers, which could speak to a very strong past life connection, or someone that will feel very familiar, feel like, you know, you have something in common when you meet this person. Someone that really, there's this synergy or this chemistry between you and this person. Strong and powerful union. When you think of the lovers in traditional tarot, you could see that angel that oversees that union, which speaks to that being a spiritual union, or a spiritual connection, or some sort of divine counterpart, because you all are in alignment, in sync, in harmony. I'm also getting like a past person. So how someone feels about you is they're very much reminiscing, pining, you know, ruminating over thoughts of you or thoughts of this love, or just kind of sitting back and just kind of like daydreaming. Perhaps they're kind of trying to connect with you telepathically or intuitively again. They do see you as someone very cerebral, intuitive, and psychic. So that could also be something that could be a little intimidating, as I was picking up earlier. They're also very attracted to you because we have the 1 new beginning here for when we pull what's hidden. So what's hidden is you have someone very strongly attracted to you. What we have playing right now is we have Dr. Dre, Still Dre, featuring Snoop. Someone could be from California, Long Beach, Compton, I'm hearing. But with Dr. Dre, someone could also be a doctor. You know, you could be either a medical doctor, a dental hygienist, or you could also be just like someone who got your doctorate in, you know, I'm hearing psychology, or your doctorate in English, or some sort of political science. I'm hearing even actual like science, like whether it's a physicist or some sort of neuroscientist. But I get someone who has like a doctorate and they are a doctor. And it could be medical, it could be anything, but I'm getting, or someone could be going to school for that. But with Still Dre, even if you've like achieved some major level of success in your life, you're still cool in the game. You're still the same. It's like, this is what, you're very humble. And this is what makes you so attractive, because it's like someone has watched you kind of level up slowly but surely. It's like that independence. It just really looks good on you. But you're still humble. You're still down to earth. You're not walking around snooty with your head up in the air. Like, it's all about you. It's just, you're just cool. And someone is really like admiring you with this 1 new beginning. I definitely see you're on the precipice of something new. There could be this connection could be re-sparked. There could be some sort of re-spark after a conversation. What we have here, like I said, is four and six is 10 yet again. So all the cards that were on the deck, remember, it was four, and when we pull the card for how someone feels about you, that's a six, so that makes it 10. So I do feel like the wheel is turning or something's coming full circle, especially with this new beginning, because the 10 reduces to one, so that's confirming also, even with these cards. And I want to just show you again, 26 and five, that eight and that five is 13, that's four, 41 and 67, the 41 is five, the 67 is 13, that's four. So the 2, 6, 8, and the 5, that's 13, that's 4. The 41, that's 5, that's 9. 9 and 4, the 67, that breaks down to 13, that's 4. That's also 4. So the 4 and then the 6 of the love, that makes it 10. So I just wanted to break it down for sake, and that 10 becomes 1. So how someone feels is if there were delays, if there was some confusion, if you moved on, if you set up boundaries, if you stepped away, if someone got lost in translation because they were confused or not sure or lacked confidence or just was trying to just be out in them streets or out there, you know, they just out there doing them their thing, like I said, soiling their royal oats, or if they just wanted to play the field, whatever the case may be, it's like now it's circling back around to you because maybe they got their fill of what was out there and it just wasn't satisfying, it wasn't nourishing, it wasn't stimulating, it just wasn't hitting on nothing. And now they're realizing with you how they feel about you is this. You know, you're the true definition of love. You know, it's still there because I'm getting still Dre. Someone's name could be Dre. Someone's name could be Calvin, because that's, I believe, that's Snoop's real name is Calvin. Calvin brought us, if I'm not mistaken. And we have Cindy Lauper, Girls Just Want to Have Fun. So as I was saying, someone wanted to be out in them streets. So they roll old, just be out there, do their own thing. And that's what it was. They just wanted to have fun. They was non-committal, flighty, perhaps. And I feel like now they're thinking about all of this. And now they're realizing they want a new beginning, a fresh start. They want to try again. This is someone that's definitely very passionate and attractive, attracted towards you because they find you attractive. And they could just have this, like, this could be something that's destined also. Because that 10 that all these cards reduce to, I'm just getting something destined. I'm getting a very harmonious union. I'm getting two people who have this undying chemistry, connection, you know, synergy, commonality, familiarity, and love. Like, there's just something, you know, that is just undeniable about this connection. And that could be perhaps the reason why this new beginning is coming back, because I feel like perhaps your angels, your ancestors are bringing you into alignment. When I think of the number four, which is what all these cards, you know, with the person who you're attracting or who or what you're attracting to you, the four, that also is giving me like the four of wands, someone who wants to rebuild, someone who wants that stability, someone who sees you as that happily ever after, or that person that they can have that happy spouse, happy house type of vibration with. So this is someone that's very serious about what they want. And with Girls Just Want to Have Fun, they may see you as someone very fun, lighthearted, you know, as I said, like, a, you know, very much a safe space. Someone's emotionally intelligent. And we have Cindy Lauper. So someone's name could be Cindy. Someone could be from Britain, Europe. Someone could be, you know, could have formerly been like a punk rocker, or someone just has a very different style, you know, just a different aesthetic, just very different, very unique, you know, and that's what you stand, you stand out from the rest. And so with this 22 intuition, follow your intuition always. I was speaking of the number two early because that 11 showed up, which is here. Look at that. So 222 is what I'm getting from that. That's your intuition. Just confirm and follow your intuition. Trust what you're feeling, you know, in your gut. Your gut will never steer you wrong. Your gut is going to give you that instinct, that gumption. It's your second brain, so follow it. You know, but what's hidden is, you know, listen to your intuition. I feel someone is also mirroring you. You have, you know, someone mirroring you, or someone could be making some sort of connection, because you have someone who's equally in tune, equally psychic, or equally spiritually aware, you know. And that 22 breaks down to 4, so this can be that same divine masculine. And with just want to have fun, be mindful, because maybe someone is coming around just to have some fun. You know, maybe this is someone who was very reserved in the past. Maybe now they want to be a little more adventurous. It could be either way. We'll learn more as we clarify. But with individuality here on the bottom of the deck, the outcome, perhaps that could have been what took place. Maybe someone was out there having a lot of fun, and that's the reason why, you know, you ended up single. Or maybe someone's going to break free from a situation because they find out that someone that they were with or connected to was having a lot of fun, and that's going to, you know, kind of catapult them into something where they're going to be by themselves. They're going to have time to kind of reflect, get time to work on themselves, and through that contemplative state or meditative state, I should say, they're going to start to realize their feelings, you know, because they're now in tune and in touch. You know, they're now seeing things from a different perspective in that hermit mode. So this is powerful. So let's tap in. What is the outcome for my beloved Scorpios? Let me get a message of peace, power, and protection. We got 844 on the clock. And that 844 breaks down to 16, which breaks down to 7. So someone could have absolutely had some sort of tower moment. And I did speak to completions and endings and, you know, chapters closing and cycles, you know, ending and wrapping up. So this is just confirming that 9 also is speaking to someone could be giving birth in 9 days, 9 weeks. Someone could be in their 9th month, you know, or someone could simply just be completing and wrapping up a cycle. As I said, 9 is the highest number of change. And we did pull that number 5, the change card. So something has changed. There could have been some conflicts and challenges which triggered, you know, it was very triggering, which forced the change. And those things happen for a reason, you know. Steel sharpens steel. So those experiences have sharpened you, has made you stronger. It's built character. So the card that flew out is we have 32 music. This card always comes out for Scorpios. Many of you are musicians. You could play instruments, or you may very well be a singer, a hip-hop artist, a jazz artist. You could be a rock and roll artist. You could be a reggae artist. You could be a DJ. You could be someone who is a music teacher, or you could be in music class. But there's something about music that is just, it constantly comes out. And the song that's playing right now is Bon Jovi, Living on a Prayer. So many of you are very praying people. You are prayer warriors. So even through all of these hurdles and these very challenging times, it has not stumped you, because you continue to pray. You continue to be prayer warriors. You continue to see yourselves in the exact positions that you wanted to be in, instead of seeing yourselves as victims or seeing yourself in some sort of you just didn't see yourself as a victim. Let's just leave it there. And so that could have catapulted you. That could have transformed the circumstance as well. With Living on a Prayer, I feel like that's how you live your life daily, is just by walking in faith and not by sight. And praying. You wake up and you pray. You may say gratitude prayers. You may write in your journal. But you wake up with a purpose. And that's the reason why you've been able to break through, you know, a lot of the challenges that others are just astounded by. They're like, how, when, where, who, are you? Like, they're confused, beloveds, you know. And with this 32, again, maturation is what I'm getting. A lot of you could also be clairaudient. Many people could also be like listening to music and it's making them think of you, whether it's the, you know, maybe this song in particular resonates with some of you. Maybe there's a loved one that may have transitioned where this was like a special song to them. And this is the way that they're communicating with you, just reminding you to pray, or reminding you to be in the moment, be here now, you know, to not live in the past, not even in the future, but be here now. Because a lot of people, they focus too much on what took place in the past, so they can't see what's happening now. And then there's others who are so far up in the future that they can't appreciate this now, this moment right now, which is the present, you know? So it's like, that's what spirit is telling you, is to like be here now. And someone very well may have like a very special you know, connection or a special memory connected to this song. So with Bon Jovi, some of you all that could, you could have had a major crush on him back in the days for some of you. But I do feel like with, you know, that 32, that is the, you know, the throat chakra. So, you know, as I said, some of you could be musicians. So that could be your form of expression, your creative expression. You know, perhaps maybe some of you are artistic, and that could be another form of expression. Whatever it is, you're mastering your style and sharpening your sword, which is maturing you, because you're now believing and leaning in your actual gifts that you were born with. And with this nine completion, I do feel like there's a cycle wrapping up, and there's an opportunity now for things to transform in your life. I see the rebirth card on the bottom of the deck, the 91 surrender, the 19 pride. And these cards are like literally interchangeable, because you got the 19, see that? So when someone has an ego death, they're able to surrender. So someone could have been, you know, really just kind of fighting the situation, or just flighty, like I said, just wanting to have fun, like Cyndi Lauper was singing, you know, just really out there, just wanting to be out in them streets. You know what I'm talking about? Like they wasn't ready to settle down, or so they thought, you know. But let's tap in. We're going to clarify these messages and see what additional messages we have. Let me see what cards we're going to use this time around. What are we gonna use there? Okay, we're gonna use, in the spirit of Halloween, beloveds, we're gonna use the Halloween deck. How about that? Let's see what we got on the bottom of the deck. So we have Vampire. So you are very much aware of when you have an energy vampire. This says emotional intelligence. So that's what you go by. You go by what you're feeling in your spirit, in your gut. If it doesn't sit right in your spirit, you are off that. So that makes you very emotionally intelligent, very in tune, you know. So with this vampire, you could have been dealing with someone who was very much an emotional, like just emotionally, like they left you emotionally bankrupt. But this is what leveled you up to becoming emotionally intelligent, as I was saying, because we're clarifying the 26 love partnership and this five change. So this is the, this was the you know, that nail in the coffin that I was picking up, you know, because the 13 is the death card, you know. And so with this energy, that's why you have this vampire here, because it's confirming that that was like the catalyst, if you will. And the card that's here on the split is, we have the lamp, remembrance. So what did I say about, you know, it possibly being someone from the past? Because I was not only seeing like the Six of Cups, but I was also, you know, seeing like, you know, the Lovers. But this is given someone from the past energy. You know, because that's the only reason why someone could have regret, or someone could be in some, you know, hangman state looking at things differently. Only if, you know, they have some sort of history, you know, if you planted seeds and roots. So next we have Bonnie Tyler, and this is total eclipse of the heart. So maybe that eclipse back in August, you know, could have like severed some sort of tie or some sort of yoke, or someone could have cut someone free during that time. Whatever the case may be, that was a very liberating thing. And I also see a lantern in the window, and in this deck, the lantern is represents or symbolizes, I should say, protection. So this could be, in fact, you know, that divine connection or spiritual union that I was picking up earlier. And with the lantern, it is coming, that is the epiphany, the aha, because that produces light, the light that you need to see the truth. And that lantern is in the window so that someone could make it home or see, you know, that, okay, you're welcomed. You're welcomed back here, beloved. So let's tap it. Let's see what we got coming in, going out, going on, beloved. Let's clarify these messages. Let me get a message for my beloved Scorpio spirit. So this card just jumped out and stood up like, pick me. And so what we have on the bottom of the deck is we have Owl, wise seeing, wise knowing. And this will be the card in the bottom of the deck when we pull who or what you're attracting to you. So remember what I said about someone watching? So they're learning, because I was getting someone learning. So you could be a student and a teacher at the same time. So they're getting wiser. They're getting more mature, because remember, we have the 41 self-discipline and the 67 physical activity for who or what you're attracting. But the card that actually flew out to clarify the 26 love partnership and 5 change for the overall energy is we have ghost, regret. Didn't I literally just say that? Someone's dealing with regret and guilt. Someone is dealing with, you know, a little bit of regret because now they're seeing something. And with this total eclipse of the heart, you know, it says turn around in parentheses. So now they wish to turn around, come back again. Remember, we had opened up the reading with Abby Okai saying running. So this was that runner, chaser type of dynamic. Maybe you felt like you was always chasing someone. And you just stopped chasing them. You just stopped. You were no longer interested. It wasn't fulfilling. You didn't feel like you were in a safe space. You felt like you were dealing with someone who was emotionally stunted. And so it kind of turned you off. But when you got turned off, you established boundaries and you started to work on yourself and focus on loving you. And by loving yourself, that has now made you more attractive. So this person is learning and growing wiser by watching you, because remember, we got self-discipline. So now they're learning from you. They're becoming more mature, and they have in many ways, you know, leveled up, or they have evolved in some way, shape, form, or fashion. And this is due to, you know, watching you. The owl is definitely saying this person is keeping tabs. Owls can see in the night. They have very sharp, you know, vision. They can see prey a mile away. Like they are very sharp. They're nighttime predators. So some of you also could be hearing owls outside of your home. That could be a sign that, you know, someone is definitely coming in, if that resonates. But this also is a testament to someone becoming wiser, because owls are very intelligent birds. Very intelligent. So this just speaks to someone growing up, someone leveling up. Divine spirit of peace, power, and protection. Why is this 41 self-discipline and 67 physical activity here for who or what Scorpios are attracting to them? And we have now werewolf, and it says exploring wildness. So this was someone who was definitely exploring, as I was saying, you know, soiling their royal oats, just trying to see what was out there, trying to get their feel, you know, just trying to have a little bit of fun. That's the energy. They were just wild. I'm hearing you a wild boy. I'm hearing that. You a wild boy. Like, you know, and that's what someone was. They was just wild. They was just out there. But now they're more disciplined. Now they've matured. This is the energy. And that physical activity is, you know, 13. So that's the transformation. They actively worked on themselves. This is someone that definitely made a conscious decision to change. And what we have playing right now is we got scorpions. And this is called wind of change. I can't make this ish up. This is Scorpion. So Scorpios, the wind of change. This person caught wind of the changes and transformations that you had, and they took notes. What did I say about you? You inspired someone or triggered someone to transform. So the wind of change, that's what this person did. They actively worked on themselves so that they can now be on your wavelength, on your frequency, because they realized that they made some mistakes. That's why they're riddled with guilt. And if this person is someone that may have ghosted you, or you may have ghosted them, because with this ghost and the regret card, you know, that's what I'm getting a sense of. I feel like this person is also, I feel like when I hear ghost, I feel like they're being It's like they're being traumatized by memories of you or thoughts of you, you know, that's really troubling to them. What's on the bottom of the deck was we have Skull of Stars, infinite possibilities. So when you think of that infinity symbol, that represents what goes around, it comes back around again. And how they see you is someone that they can, you know, have that happily ever after with, because we got the love. This is what we're about to clarify. So the sixth love, what goes around comes back around again. So this is that person from the past that wants another shot. They want to take their shot or shoot their shot. This is someone who's become wiser. This is someone who sees you as very strong. They see you as someone who's also planted a lot of seeds. Like you've planted seeds in good faith. But I'm also getting a sense of like karma. You know, because when I think of infinite, you know, the infinity symbol, as I said, that's the number eight sideways. But we're in a universal, you know, eight universal year right now. And this is a year of karma. So this could have been a karmic connection, a karmic relationship, you know, but they see that now the seed you sowed has somehow granted you infinite possibilities, whereas the seeds that they've sown has somehow cost them a lot of hurt and pain, you know. And it's because you did things, you perhaps, if this is you or their energy, who or what, because I'm doing a reading for Scorpios, I always speak as you being the first person I'm discussing. But it's like whatever they did, it definitely cost them you, because you were always acting from a place of love. You were always acting from a place of loyalty or faithfulness. You were always providing that safe space. You were always there. And that's something they may have taken for granted. And we have Michael Jackson, Beat It now. So that's you may have told this person to beat it, kick rocks, wear open-toed sandals. You know what I'm talking about? Like, this is someone who definitely is, you know, feeling a little bit, because even in the video, you see like there's two gangs warring with each other. So this is someone who is definitely having some sort of instability. You know, they were stuck in two minds. They didn't really know what they wanted. They didn't know what they wanted, you know. So let's tap in. So why is this six love here for who, how this person, Scorpios, are attracting to them, feel about them? And the lamp remembrance is still here. So those are those nostalgic thoughts. Remember, you know, kind of ruminating and pining, thinking, sitting in the window. And there goes that protection card. I told y'all, didn't I mention the jack-o'-lantern? And I was saying that this was, you know, the protection, because I was speaking to this jack-o'-lantern. Look at that. See how universe works? I can pull the card because this is on the bottom of the deck. There you go. And I was saying that this is a connection that could be protected, because we're clarifying this six love. And when you think of the lovers, the angel oversees it. So this person may very well be your twin flame, soulmate, your divine counterpart. This could be a spiritual union. This could be someone that is divinely meant for you, because we have the protection. This is how someone also sees you, as being very spiritually protected, or you are someone who's very protective of your own energy. You know, you may have protective walls up, boundaries could be guarded, but you're also very protected. Because we have this protection card. So they see you as someone who is absolutely like you. You have a divine force that watches over you. And with Beat It, that could be the reason why they could have some sort of intimidation, because they may feel like you may reject them this time around, because you're so protective of your feelings. With this, the lamp remembrance on the bottom of the deck, we're about to clarify the intuition card. So spirit is just reminding someone to remember what took place. Like, it's always important to look back in awareness, but to not look back, stay there, you know, and whimper about not being able to go back. No, just look back in awareness, learn, and then continue to get, you know, continue to push forward. So why is this 22 intuition here for what's hidden in the energy? Okay, so a card just flew up and flew back in, and we have Night Song, Hidden Talents. So with that intuition and Night Song, some of you could be seeing a beautiful red card. No, that's the masculine energy. So that could be an ancestor in the spirit realm, whether it's your father, your grandfather, uncle, a brother, a cousin, a friend that you're dear to. With this Night Song, you may be hearing like bird calls. You know, it's daylight savings time is coming up, so maybe, you know, even though it's daytime, it's still night, but birds, you know, especially around where I'm at, the birds start singing around like, they never stop, it seems like, but really they start picking up around like 4 or 5. I'll hear birds singing outside of my window. So maybe you're waking up to that. Those are signs, maybe those are signs that your angels are, you know, kind of giving you these little signs and synchronicities. To trust your intuition. If you hear some sort of cardinal singing, it's like spirit is telling you really to trust your intuition. Those are messages, because birds are very angelic. You know, they're symbolic of, you know, receiving messages from the angels, from the heavens, from the ancestors. But with this hidden talent, this could also be telling you to trust your intuition when it comes to some of those skills and gifts and talents that you've been honing, whether it's artistic or creative. It's like you have some sort of hidden talent that spirit wants you to embark upon or take action on, because I feel like you have a very unique position. You have a very unique perspective, or you have something that you can bring to the table that is very innovative. That's very beautiful. And the next card we have is Death. And I mentioned the Death card, and here we are. It says the eternal cycle begins here. So transformation, things that end now have a new beginning. Whatever dies, it is transformed, or it is reincarnated, or it reemerges. And so with this music, maybe there is a spark, a love. Maybe you have a different perspective. Maybe if you were a musician years ago and you stopped because you started a family, or you went to school, or you did X, Y, and Z. We have the Bee Gees playing right now, Staying Alive. But maybe there's songs, you know. Maybe this song in particular, Staying Alive, or maybe there's memories that just gives you some sort of second breath. You know, it's like you're just looking for a sign that, yeah, this is what you're supposed to be doing. Because it says the eternal cycle begins here, and then it's right next to the hidden talents. So some of you are musicians. Some of you have, you know, hung up your microphones, or you put your guitars away. You haven't played that piano. It's collecting dust. It got clothes sitting on it. Spirit is telling you that you have these hidden talents that you need to hone. You need to get back to what it is that you love, because it keeps you alive. You know, whenever you're doing what you truly love and are passionate about, it's like it breathes life into you. And not only that, but you also can inspire the conscious, the collective. Like you can literally inspire and help heal the collective as well. This is powerful. So Divine Spirit, why is this 32 music here for our beloved Scorpios, for what the overall energy is? Why is this 32 music here for the overall, and I mean for the outcome, pardon me. And we have the Skeleton, the Strength card on the bottom of the deck. So you are very strong. You are strong, you are powerful, you are wise, you are capable, and the card that flew out is Winter, and it says, the sacredness of pausing, beautiful. So the sacredness of pausing, Winter. And remember, the winter time is when you are supposed to go into hibernation. The winter time is when all of the flowers and all of the trees and all of plant life, it dies, but then it reborn. So that's that same energy of death and rebirth. So this is a beautiful time for you to pause, to take space within yourself, to meditate, to get it straight, you know, but also to be in a space of mindfulness. This gives you an opportunity to look at things and be more aware, to decrease any type of demand you may have on yourself or other people, and just really hone in and focus in on yourself. And you have to remember, wherever you go, there you are. So in other words, you cannot run from anything. You can't run from your shadow. You can't run from the truth. So that's why it's very important, you know, that you are here now, so that you can deal with whatever is going on. The winter time is a time of hibernation, incubation, contemplation, transformation. This is a very beautiful energy. This is beautiful, y'all. You know, there's a lot of leaves falling. Some of you may have, you know, yards where there's just leaves everywhere, these beautiful leaves. The fall is a very beautiful time, very beautiful. The trees just start turning all these different colors, these array of colors. But you have to definitely take a pause, take a moment for self, especially after your soul returns, you know, after the holy days, after those, that time, it's like really important for you to really connect with the self, because we're ushering into a brand new year. It's a nine universal year. And we know nine, like I said, is the highest number of change. There's going to be a lot of changes next year. Trust me, a lot of things are going to change. And you got to be prepared. You got to be ready mentally, emotionally, spiritually, because we are currently under spiritual warfare. We're always under that type of attack. And that's why it's very important to, you know, really be mindful of what you're listening to, what energy you're putting out, because where your attention goes, energy flows. So you got to be mindful not to feed the wrong type of beasts. That's why I don't watch the news. That's why I don't participate in half the ish they be telling us to do. I'd be like, nah, I'm off on that. I'm going this way. It'd be a gazillion people going that way. I'm going to go the opposite direction. And that's what's kept me alive for 50 years, because I don't do what everybody else does, you know. And that's what I would suggest you all do. Don't do what you feel you're supposed to do just to keep the peace. Don't never appease and please. And don't conform. If you don't feel it, remember what Spirit said, trust your own intuition. It's very important now to use discernment now. You can't even listen to your own family, let alone strangers on a box. You know what I'm talking about? Whether that be your TV, your television, or whether that be your laptop or your phone. You know, you got. That's why you have to go within, because the answers you seek are always found within. So, Divine Spirit, let's get some more messages. So, we're going to clarify these messages, and then we're going rada. So, let's see what we got. We're going to go with the telepathy, because I get a lot of messages, you know, are coming through intuitively. So, let's see what we have. So, look, we got the Strength card on the bottom of the deck yet again. And it says, the power of love is like a magnet. I can't read backwards. I thought I could. Okay, so the power of love is like a magnet drawing souls together. So obviously there is love, a deep love, a sacred love, a past life love. You know, love is definitely a very powerful emotion. And so I do feel, and what's interesting is I heard that love isn't even, that's not even the most powerful emotion. There were studies that showed authenticity is the most powerful emotion through studies. So being your authentic self is what's going to bring about some sort of love or some sort of change in a love ship. And remember, when you were tied to individuals that were not loving you right, not reciprocating, you know, just constantly taking but not putting any deposits, any love deposits, any of that, that's why the connection failed. So when you are being loved authentically by being your authentic self and by teaching people how to treat you, now you can attract what you are. And we have the Bee Gees, how deep is your love? So there is someone that could be circling back, that could be expressing how deeply they love you, because it says the power of love is like a magnet. And I was getting that you're very magnetic, very attractive, because self-love is very attractive. So let's tap in on the split. We have heart. It says you start to feel your heart beat faster as you get closer. So if there is anyone that you're thinking of right now, from your past, your present, whatever, where you can't even explain the type of feelings, emotions, you can't explain why your heart gets to beating fast around this person. Maybe this is the person that's thinking of you. This is the epiphany they're having. That's love, beloved. Those nerves you feeling, that's love. You know, that nervousness, you sweating, palms sweaty, and you don't know what to say. You're stumbling and fumbling. You're constantly thinking of this person you haven't seen in 5, 6, 7 years. That's love, beloved. They're starting to realize that. And with how deep is your love, that could be their question for you, because they know they feel deeply about you, but they're not sure how you may feel about them. Someone's name could start with B or G, first, middle, or last. So Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection, we're going to clarify these messages, and then we're going to wrap it up. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Okay, so a card just got back. And so what we have is boundary. So this is why they want to know how deeply your love is, because you have established boundaries, like I said. You're not playing with anybody. You know, that experience may have taught you some valuable lessons about self-love, self-worth, self-value. And so it says having sensible boundaries is important. So they can understand your reasons why you transformed and started to protect yourself, because they are responsible perhaps for you building the wall. And so that's why they have regrets, because now they don't know how to climb over or knock down the walls. So that's why they were questioning, how deep is this person love me? Because I know I have fallen, you know, I haven't risen, I've fallen in love. And so with Queen, another one bites the dust. So, you know, you could be someone who's like a heartbreaker, you know, you could be someone that they may see as a heartbreaker, and maybe they see, you know, maybe this was someone who was like a player, because I'm getting like a player, playerette. And this is Queen, that's why I was picking up initially the female could have been like a heartbreaker. So yeah, this is definitely someone feels like you broke their heart. They're definitely heartbroken, because I was even getting with the 12. You know, when you break that down, I was getting the Three of Swords. And they feel even more heartbroken and regrets. You know, just, you know, remorse and shame, because now there's walls that you have built. And so they're not sure how to break them down. They're not even sure how to get in contact with you, I feel. I feel like there's someone who's just watching from behind the scenes, or shadow, you know, like kind of behind the shadows or whatever. What we have on the bottom of the deck, is I'm talking about somebody watching you behind the scenes, is we have observe. We have observe. So someone is definitely observing you. And it says, notice all the noteworthy things in your relationship. And we're about to pull the card for who or what you're attracting to you. So someone was exploring wildness, which means I feel someone was creeping, because I'm hearing, so I creep, yeah, I just keep it on the down low, because nobody is supposed to know. So I'm hearing that. I heard TLC so loud. So that's why. So now they're observing. It's almost like what they put out, they got back, you know. Because you attract what you are. So they could have been like running around, kind of got, you know, kind of locked down by somebody that was just as much a player as them. And so now they learned, you know. But let's tap in, because it says another one bites the dust. So they could have definitely, you know, they could have become, what you call it? They could have fell by their own, like fell on their own sword. You know, very, very interesting. So let's tap in. Let's see what we got. So Divine Spirit, Peace, Power, and Protection. We're going to clarify these messages. My spirit of peace, power, and protection. Why is this 41 self-discipline, 67 physical activity, and werewolf exploring wildness here? For who or what our beloved Scorpios are attracting to them. And then we're going to wrap it up. My spirit of peace, power, and protection. Thank you, spirit. It's like 50 billion cards keep falling. All right, this time it's not 50 billion. We're going to take those. Thank you, spirit. Because 20 just fell, and I was like, nah. All right, so we got marriage, and this is on the bottom of the deck when we pull how they feel about you. And it says, the marriage of souls is the union of two divine opponents. And remember, that is going to be clarifying the sixth love and the jack-o'-lantern protection. And I was saying that this was a spiritual union, a divine counterpart, two of the same words that I was saying in my description of this person I was seeing. There it is. So let's tap in, beloveds. I can't make this up. And what's underneath that? We got barrier. Find ways around obstacles to find happiness. See that? This is what's on the bottom of the deck when we pull how they feel about you. And I told you, you built up a wall. You're very protective of your energy. You know, especially if this is the person that may have hurt you in the past. You already pulled boundary for the overall energy. You know, and now we got barriers. So they do feel these walls, because I was seeing the Nine of Wands. And then I was also seeing like you, you know, making sure to move away from all of the negativity to a focus on self-love. What we have playing right here, right now, is Mario, Let Me Love You. You should let me love you. So now they're having a difference of opinion, a different, you know, like a change of heart. Someone's name could be Mario. So someone definitely is now really looking at you like, you should let me love you, because now they realize, you know, that they know how to love you right, you know, and they now realize like they weren't doing their part in the past. So the cards that actually flew out for how they, for who or what you're attracting to you, is we have the Strength card. So we did see that. So this is very powerful. This was in the split when we first touched this deck. So the Strength card, they're trying to muster up the strength, courage, and wise dome. And they cannot fight the attraction that they feel. You know, they feel like they feel drawn to you. There's this magnet that's drawing them to you. They are intrigued. They are very much mesmerized. We have recognition, we have link, and we have connection. So the recognition card, it says the universe will help you recognize signs and miracles. So they're recognizing this because they're in that sacrificial position, which is allowing them to see you, see things in a whole new light. They also have link, which says the bond of love grows stronger over time. So that time apart, remember you had that time out where there was obviously time apart, time away from one another. That's what's intensifying, is that time apart. And then we also have connection. Your connection is eternal and unbreakable. That sounds like a past life love to me. That sounds like someone you have a very sacred bond and connection with to me, which is everything that I was describing even before we touched the cards, beloved. Thank you, Spirit, for the confirmations. I am honored. So the marriage of souls is the union of two divine opponents. They could see you as wifey. They could see you as hubby. They could see you as the mother or father to their child, their children. They could see you as their partner, their life partner. They could see you as someone that they wake up to for the rest of their life, and they will be happy with that. There's someone that you could grow old, grow wise with. Like, this is what they see. They see marriage. They see ceremony, matrimony. They see you walking down this aisle and jumping over the broom with them. This is what they see. Partnership, longevity, generational love, family, wills. This is what they see. Building. They see camaraderie. They see unity. They see these beautiful, this beautiful connection. This is amazing. Why is six love and the jack-o'-lantern protection card here for how this person, our beloved Scorpios, are attracting to them, feel about them? Thank you, Spirit. That card flew out. And it says embrace. Embrace what fate has in store for you is on the bottom of the deck when we pull what's hidden. So it sounds like you do have a divine talent, but it says clarity. Didn't I say someone has had some sort of epiphanous moment? Because we had aha. I'm saying they had an aha moment. They're seeing you differently. Obviously now, after being in that sacrificial position of the hangman, forced to look at things from a different perspective, a different vantage point, with a different pair of lens. It says take a moment to think about your situation, to figure it out. So they're thinking, all right. Not only are they thinking, but look at Michael Jackson coming right on time. But they're remembering the time. That's that energy of ruminating, pining, thinking. I told you they were in a very cerebral place, just really thinking and reminiscing, you know, on what took place in the past. That's that person from the past. I can't make this up. Thank you, Spirit. I can't make this up. Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection. Why is it 22? Intuition, night song. Hidden talents. That could even be talking about right now with me, you know, doing this reading and all these songs playing. Some of you could be clairaudient. Someone also could be very clairaudient where they, you know, get to get messages through the songs, through the lyrics. And we have heart on the bottom of the deck. You start to feel your heart beat faster as you get closer. Didn't I just describe that? I just described that just like a few moments ago. Rewind! You know what I'm talking about? Like they feel intense feelings, emotions, passion, things that are undescribable when they're around you. Sometimes it could be intimidating because they don't understand why they feel so deeply, whoever this is. And this is someone that has love. This is someone that really genuinely loves you. And I feel it's a masculine because the red cardinals are masculine energy. And red is associated with passion, lust, and all of those deep emotions. And we have acceleration. Speed up and chase the results you want. So they ready to chase your ass because they feel like it's now or never, beloved. It says speed up and chase. They done let too much time slip past. And we also have union. The union of divine soul counterparts is a miraculous event that begins when you least expect it. So that's why you got to look alive, beloved, because this is coming in when you least expect it. Perhaps intuitively you're picking up on it. This could be even, you know, this divine masculine that I was picking up with this number 22, the four, you know, someone could really be realizing like, you know, I want to build with this person, or I want to rebuild what was once destroyed, you know, and whatever they're feeling, it's intensifying, it's accelerating, which means that they could possibly come in unexpectedly, quickly, just out of nowhere, poof, they're here, you know, and with this union, I'm absolutely feeling like this is that person from the past, or that divine counterpart, that spiritual union that I was discussing the whole time. Because it says the soul counterparts. And these are all words that I used. You know, everything that I keep touching is like, I just said that. Rewind. I'm going to start doing videos where I'm going to say, you know, like, I'm going to show the intro before I touch the cards. And then I'll show as the reading progresses how everything, or those key notes that I pointed out, how it comes out in the reading. Just so you can see, I don't play. I'm not playing with this. Or should I say spirit doesn't play? You know, because I'm getting it from them. So, but I give honor to them for giving me this gift of intuition and clairaudience. So we do have this Remember the Time still playing. And we got 32 music. And we have winter. We're clarifying that message. So let's see what the cards have to say. And heart is on the bottom. It says you start to feel your heart beat faster as you get closer. And some, like I said, someone's name could be Michael or Jackson. So divine spirit of peace, power, and protection. Wow, a lot of cards just flew out. And we have yes, trust your intuition. And remember, the intuition card is, you know, in the energy of what's hidden. So that's what spirit wants you to do. Because someone may come back like, you know, do you remember the times? Trying to, you know, kind of pull and tug on your emotional strings to see where you're at. But, you know, always follow your intuition. Always follow your intuition. It will never steer you wrong. So let's see what the cards have to say. So the cards that flew out is we have guilty. So someone has a very guilty conscience. And it says, don't let guilt get in the way of happiness. So this is that same person that's struggling with regret. You know, so they're having some difficulty with how to approach, like I said, how to start the conversation, spark the conversation, how to clear the air, because they are riddled with regret. And because they see you as someone very intuitive, you have self-love, you're self-aware, you're very strong, you're independent now. It's like they don't know how to approach you. And so they may come back and try to be lighthearted and just bring up past memories. Like, remember that time when we did X, Y, Z? You know, let's say, like, just to be, you know, kind of put you in the space where you can be more open and receptive to them. The next card we have is value. Focus on things of value. So perhaps that's another thing. They did not value you, because that's why you had to, you know, really walk away to show self-love. You know, and that's the reason why they also had to start implementing some form of change within themselves, because it cost them you. So now they value you, they see you, they honor you. You know, they really, really appreciate the person that you are now, because they're realizing that you are rare. You're not someone that they're going to bump into again in this lifetime. Next card we have is accept. So it says, be prepared to accept what fate has in store for you. So they're willing to accept whether you reject them or not, but they absolutely are feeling almost beholden to the fact that they have to at least try to get your attention or to communicate what they're feeling, because they've been holding this back for quite some time. The next card we have is 1111. So that's that four. This is a twin flame. Remember, I mentioned the 1111 when I saw the that four, when I was discussing the divine masculine is like that 1111. And I was breaking down that that's the number of twin flame. This is, you know, that energy of someone that wants to build with you. And it says 1111 is an important number for twin flames, symbolizing harmony and balance in soulmates. So this is absolutely something that you could achieve with this person if they come from a place where they are being, you know, accountable, honest, open. You know, where they're being their authentic self. Because remember, when I started earlier, I went into a diatribe spirit, put it in my heart to just discuss, like, the most powerful emotion isn't even love, it's authenticity. And if you look here, we have, you know, this 1111, they have to be their authentic self. Because it says important number for twin flames, symbolizing harmony and balance. So you have to be in harmony. You have to be in emotional, spiritual equilibrium with the self, you know, before you can step into a divine counterpart. So the next energy we have is let go. It says some things are best let go and let the universe work it out in its divine time. And I mentioned divine timing. Everything happens in divine timing. So if someone did not see you, you had to let it go. And if it comes back, that means it's meant for you. How many times have we heard that in a lifetime? That if someone leaves and doesn't come back, or if they leave and come back, then that means it was divinely meant for you. That means that it was meant to be. And so that's what we are seeing here. It sounds like it was definitely a twin flame circumstance. Next, we have indication. Watch for signs that lead you to love. So you're going to see a lot of signs, synchronicities. Many of you could be seeing 1111, 555, 222, 666. You could be seeing 444 even, 555. You could be seeing a lot of signs and synchronicities, maybe even animal totems. Again, you could be seeing, hearing owls at night, or you could be hearing these cardinal birds during the daytime. You may be seeing red cardinal birds, which are the masculine energy. They usually represent like a divine masculine and masculine energy that could be in the spirit realm. So maybe a father figure, grandfather, someone who is a paternal energy. If you're seeing a brown cardinal bird, that's a feminine energy. So that could be someone that has transitioned, a loved one, a mother, grandmother, cousin, sister, auntie, someone that you love. But these signs and synchronicities are indications that there's love that's coming your way, or you're headed in love. Look at this. I can't make this up. I cannot. And it says true love. I can't make this up. It says true love appears when you least expect it. So you could bump into this person at a place that you least expect. You could be picking up a delivery package at the local post office. You could be, at UPS. You could be going to the grocery store. You could be anywhere. And this person will just, you and this person will just come into alignment. And you will know by simply the way you're feeling around this person. Your heart may start to begin to become accelerated. Your hands might start to get, sweaty. You might feel these feelings and emotions that you may never have felt. And those are all signs, that this is that person that spirit has been telling you is coming all this time. The song that is playing right now is the Beatles' Don't Let Me Down. Someone could be from the UK, Europe. Don't Let Me Down. This is someone that's not going to let you down this time around, because I feel like they definitely have learned some valuable lessons. If this is someone that you're familiar with. But I also feel if this is someone new that you're not familiar with, or you may have known from a past life, I feel like whatever they have experienced has prepared them for you, have prepared them for this time right now. And this is a very, very beautiful energy. I just want to get some messages from tarot, because I got everything but tarot cards, and I do want to just confirm with the tarot deck, and then we will wrap it up. So I'm gonna pull from the melanated deck. That's what we're gonna do. And look what we have on the bottom of the melanated deck. So we have the World, and whenever you see that World, that means that you have completely wrapped up a cycle. This is saying something has come to its completion. And every ending, look at that on the split, is a new beginning. Got the Ace of Wands. So that's confirming everything that I've said. You've graduated. You've leveled up. Absolutely. You're seen as someone who has, you've become spiritually awakened. You have tapped into Christ consciousness. You may have even learned from, past pains and hurts. But you've cut off all of the people, places, and things that were no longer serving you. And you've also learned, to prioritize yourself. You've learned a lot. I feel like you're very, very wise. You're more logical now than you've ever been. You're not as you don't go just with your emotions. You have to be in harmony with your logic and your emotion now. And we have right now heart alone. So I do feel like that time alone has really allowed you to connect with your heart, to open up your heart even, to correction. Because when you've been wronged so long, you've been hurt so long, I do feel like there was a lot of healing that was required for your heart chakra. But you've learned a lot, You've definitely learned a lot. So Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection, let me get a message from my beloved Scorpio. I was going to clarify these messages. Look at this. There goes that Four of Wands that I was talking about. That 1111 energy. You see that 1111? That Four of Wands, stability. That's the Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine, coming into union, coming into partnership. This is beautiful. So Divine Spirit, I'm cutting the deck. Remember, I cut until I feel or hear Spirit say that's good. Thank you, Spirit. One of my cards just fell. All right, I just heard that's good. Bottom of the deck, we have the Four of Wands. Man, I can't make this up. Four of Wands, overall energy. So they say that your twin flame connection is one that will teach you some of the greatest lessons when it comes to love. And so with this yes on the bottom of this deck, trust your intuition. I feel like this is just confirming that, you know, whomever, you know, taught you these lessons and taught you also to establish boundaries, and how to teach, you know, others how to treat you, that is why you're now coming into this divine connection. Someone sees you as someone they also can have that happily ever after, happy house, happy spouse type of energy with as well. The card that's on the bottom of the deck, when we pull who or what you're attracting to you, is we got the Death. And remember, I was already feeling like this person was going through a transformation, like they were definitely being very proactive in transforming or maturing and growing. So let's tap in. Why is this 41 self-discipline, 67 physical death, the werewolf? Thank you, Spirit. See that? I can't make this up. Bottom of the deck, we got the Strength card for when we pull the card for how they feel about you. Let me show you the cards that actually flew out for how this person you're attracting feels about you, or who or what you're attracting, I should say. So we got the Seven of Swords. So that's an energy of someone who is sneaking around, lying to kick it, you know, in and out, very flighty, can't trust them. But look at the feelings of remorse and regret. Remember, we have the Regret card. So someone is realizing whoever they was playing with and toying with, they fumbled the ball. Because when they turn around, they see that Two of Cups and realize that's the one that actually got away. So all the fun and games aren't so fun anymore because it cost them you. We got the Seven of Wands. There you are. You're not backing down and you're not letting anyone come in. Why? Because you've established boundaries because you've learned from the past. You've learned your lesson. Like, I'm not going to keep pouring into a vessel that has holes on the bottom of it. And I'm not going to keep on giving and you're taking, but you're not reciprocating. So this is you establishing boundaries. You're not letting anybody come in and play with you or your time. And there goes the Hierophant. So they realize, okay, you're highly in tune, highly aware. They understand that. So now they're trying to get on your frequency and match your vibration. And so they're learning. You know, they're tapping into their intuition as well. But this is someone who realizes that you have divine knowledge and wise dome. So you're coming into your own powers, and they realize that, which is why I felt like there was some level of intimidation. There's also there was things hidden that you were able to discover about this person, especially about what they was doing behind the scenes or behind your back, or when they were saying they was doing X, Y, Z, you found out they was doing A, B, C. It's just a whole thing that occurred. But you maintained your strength. You did not step out of your bag. You didn't come off your square. You didn't even deal with the drama. You just simply protected your energy. You just simply did what you had to do to grow and to evolve and to mature. What we have right now is Billy Idol and Eyes Without a Face. So when I hear Eyes Without a Face, that's someone watching you. Someone's name could be Billy. I definitely see someone, you know, could have been idolizing something, maybe a particular type of person. Idolatry is the devil. Like, you know what I'm talking about? Like, you shouldn't be idolizing nobody. I don't care if they on your TV screen or if they got a gazillion followers, subscribers. Don't idolize nobody. Nobody is above you because they have money or because they have this following. That is all foolishness. Idolatry is sinful. It's foolish. So perhaps someone was idolizing a certain type of woman or a certain type of man or someone, a certain characteristic of a person. And now they're having some sort of clarity about the situation. So let's clarify this energy of how they feel about you. Why is the Six Love, the Protection card, Jack-O-Lantern, and take a moment to think about your situations to figure it out, the Clarity card here, for how this person feels about you? because I do see that with this eyes without a face, they are definitely watching you. And through watching you, they're gaining this clarity. And look what's on the bottom of the deck when we pull what's hidden is the world. So someone could be at a distance. Someone could absolutely be looking to travel. And we have the Five of Wands. So this is the conflict. This is even competition. You know, they may feel like they're going to have to, like, you know, compete for your attention or compete for your heart, your love. There's definitely other people who could be in competition with you as well. And we got the Death card. So maybe this just flew out of my hand. So I feel like that's a bonus. I feel like Spirit still has something to say. That's perhaps what caused the demise, because there was so much competitive energy or so much challenging energy, conflicting energy, you know, and that's why you had to kind of like establish boundaries. You know, maybe this is them having these conflicts, mental conflicts or actual conflicts. But with the World card, I do see that there, we got the World and the Wheel. And there goes the Nine of Cups that I was telling you about earlier. You got the World and the Wheel. These are both showing something's coming full circle. And not only that, Spirit is saying that you're going to be not only recognized, but rewarded for wrapping up this cycle and completing this chapter in your life. Remember, we saw that completion card, which is confirming that you actually did the work. You know, we see those cards all the time. Karmic completion, completion, karmic completion. That means that you've been doing the work. Those of you that tune in and tap in have been doing the work. A lot of people be fronting. You know what I'm talking about? They be perpetrating the fraud like they've been doing the work. But they haven't been doing a damn thing. And you know who knows? The Most High. You know? And that's why, you know, a lot of these people be in their feelings when you telling them the real. And they get in their feelings because they know that it doesn't apply to them. But this right here is showing, like, the Nine of Cups. This is you loving yourself. This is you having that awareness, that understanding that self-love is the best love. And that's why you're so attractive. That's why you're so magnetic. That's why you're so intriguing, mysterious, unique, rare to someone, because it's like, yo, who is this? Who is this person? You know, they can't even recognize your ass. So Divine Spirit, why is 22 intuition, the night bird or night song, acceleration and union here for what's hidden in the energy? And then we're going right at Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection. And we have the Nine of Pentacles. I can't make this up. Self-sufficient, independent. This is you on your square. This is you. You've been working your ass off. This is pre-empress, pre-emperor status. Like, this is how hard you've been working and grinding. Like, you ain't been worried about nobody and what they got to say about you. You've been doing you and working on you. This is someone who takes care of themselves. They got their coins in the bank. They got their ducks in a row. You keep house. You like nice things. You like the finer things in life, but you're also humble and down to earth, and you ground the people around you. You're very giving. You could be very giving, very caring, very considerate, but you are not wasting time on people who don't appreciate. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know your worth. You don't have to sit around and beg for people's attention. So that's why this person feels guilty, regret. You know what I'm saying? That's why they understand why you had to let him go. You know, and I'm hearing that song, figure better let it go. Boom, boom, doom, boom. Looks like another love, TKO. Someone's name could be Teddy. But we have right now Lord Haran, and it says the night we met. So someone, remember I was saying someone was thinking a lot about, you know, the past, you know, just kind of sitting around and ruminating and thinking and, you know, just thinking about the past. So they might try to come back and be like, remember that time, you know, because we had Michael Jackson singing Remember the Times. And look what's on the bottom of the deck, the Two of Cups. This person is coming to give you that cup because they realize now. Is that the Two of Cups or the Six? Oh, yeah, that's the Two of Cups. I can't make this up. We just saw the Five of Cups. We knew they was missing your ass because this is in their energy or who or what you're attracting to you. And remember, I showed you the Two of Cups, and what we got on the bottom of the deck right now is the same Two of Cups. So they turned around and recognized. They realize it now. And that's why their head is down in shame, you know, thinking about all the wasted time on all of those people that they were sitting around. Maybe they was, you know, like I said, idolizing the wrong type of people, being around, you know, just superficialities, you know. but they have a heavy heart. But this 22 is here. They see that they can have this equal exchange. When I see the Two of Cups, that to me symbolizes two individuals that have taken the time to heal themselves. And when you take the time to heal thyself, you love thyself. And when you love thyself, you then know thyself. And this person seems to know thyself. And now they're ready to extend this cup of love. And it looks like you're willing to accept it, because both of you are not only, you know, extending your cups, but you're reaching for his and they're reaching for yours. And it's just a beautiful exchange, and it's beautiful. So Divine Spirit of Peace, Power, and Protection, why is 32 music? The winter card, guilty, value, accept, let go, indication, true love here for the outcome for my beloved Scorpios, and the 11-11. And then we're going to wrap it up this time for real, for real. So the night we met, someone is reminiscing on the night you met. Someone's name could be Haran, first, middle, or last. And we have, okay, thank you, Spirit. Thank you. I'm loving it. I'm loving it. And I'm loving it. Let me stop being silly. I'm delirious. I've been up all night, all day. I've just been ripping and running. So the cards we have, let me show you. We got the Three of Cups. What does that say? Reunited, and it felt so good. Look at that. The pumpkin's there. Another sign of protection, divine protection. So this is a protected union. I feel like your angels, your ancestors are aligning you with this person, especially with that 11-11 there. Then we also have the Queen of Cups. So that's your energy. You know your worth and value. This is a queen that is not going to just sit around and waste her time on foolishness, because remember, we had that emotional intelligence card. And that's what the King and Queen of Cups represent, emotional intelligence. You have the Page of Cups. So this is an offer. This is someone offering you a cup of love. This is good news. This is beautiful. You have the Six of Wands. So this is victories, breakthroughs. This is you having a couple of haters just sitting by, play hating on the sideline. But you are, pardon my back. pardon my back. You're still here celebrating my win, whether you're hating or not. But this is you. You're having a victory. The Three of Wands, something's manifesting. This is something you set intention on. This is something that you have put out into the ethers, and you see, you're anticipating this. Three of Wands is ready, set, go. This could even be the person ready to come towards you. We also have this Page of Swords, someone watching. Remember, I was picking up I Spy. There goes the King of Cups. So we got a suit. So the Queen and the King are here. The Queen and the King are here. Let me put it where it makes sense. So you see how this King is watching this Queen? And we got that Page. So there's a message coming. Someone is definitely going to say how they truly feel. We got Technotronic, pump it up, pump up the jam. So with that energy, I just feel like this is someone that's going to really, maybe they're trying to pump themselves up to offer something. Because I got this Page of Pentacles. This is something tangible. So someone is going to offer you something tangible, and you may be a little, guarded, because you have memory. You have memory. You may have a memory like an elephant, and that's why you could be very guarded, because the Four of Pentacles along with that Seven of Wands we saw, that could be a very guarded energy. But this person is trying to pump themselves up to take action, because they're connecting with their angels and their guides. And they do have to, they had to accept the facts that you let them go, but they also cannot deny the fact that they can't let this feeling just won't go away, if you will. It's like this feeling will just not go away. The feelings they have for you, it feels like it's intensifying. And so whether you realize it or not, something is about to go down. This is beautiful. I definitely feel this is like some sort of divine connection, because you pulled the Queen of Cups and the King of Cups. That is a suit. That is your energy. You could be coming into union with a fellow water sign. If that's not a water sign, you could have a, it could be anybody, because everything is on the board and we all have everything in our chart. But this is your reading, Scorpios. I hope the message has resonated. Until next time, I send a big fat ashe yo. Peace, love, and light.